phony type things and had lots of people joining in stuff. And one of the things he asked us to do was to write a stage dance to commemorate the arrival of the tall ships. So we did. And it was quite unfortunate because I was about 2 minutes before we actually performed it at this concert from the town, what we were going to call it. Arguing rage, just what it was going to be called. And so somebody said, well, what was the country song? And we said, it was a clipper ship. So somebody said, right, Dorsey Clipper, that'll do. And we went on to say, it's still called Dorsey Clipper. And that's it. So we're going to have a go at dancing it now. Derek only learned it about 10 minutes ago because I'm constantly delaying the time of the year to dance at his hill. So, see how we
thank you.
circles and squares. And the behaviors, the figures, the choruscripts of the arches. It starts with lines. Everybody starts with your right foot. Two double steps to your left. Diagonally forward, so the two sets make two ends make one line. You should finish up one line, three facing one way, three facing the other. Everybody there, good? Two on the spot. Two to go back to back with the line, with that line. And then two doubles back into place.
Through,
yeah. And then you do it in the opposite direction, so you go to the right for the second time. Two doubles into line, two doubles on the spot, two doubles to go back to back, and two doubles back through. When you go to the left, you go back passing left shoulder with your partner. When you go to the right, you go back passing right shoulder with your partner. You go to the left, you back pass left shoulder with your partner. You go out to the right, pass right shoulder with your partner.
So I can't get my right to my left. So I just left.
Just to go back.
way again and come back up their side. So the straight line goes round them all that complete circle. Do you want to just walk that again? You go through the arch, then through the archway, then make it. Four steps facing out, four steps facing down, and six steps facing into the middle. go round you. So the top couple are going to go to the middle, then face out, down to the bottom, face down, up to the middle, face in, back up to the top and face across. All you're doing is walking a square, basically. Do you want to just walk that figure again? Okay, so the top's got to the outside end, and the middle's to the bottom, come up to the middle. Everybody face out. The tops go down to the bottom, the bottoms come up to the top. Everybody faces down. Then the bottom, the tops come back up to the centre, the bottoms go down to the middle. Everybody faces in. And then everybody, you go back to your original place, at the top and down to the bottom. I shouldn't worry about which way you actually go, that's the way it's supposed to go, because it's not entirely crucial for today, okay? Just sort of aim in the right direction. Ish. Do you want to dance that one? That's squares. That's it. Okay, do a bit of music for squares. Thank you. top, so you're going to come up as a sort of straight line. So you're going to come up, that's it. So you come out like sort of two gates opening. Yeah, all right. And then you've got three steps to do that, and then we always put our stage down across them.
Thank you. say, to actually say something very, to say what sort of thing, Marguerite Stein had great candles bought in large quantities from the local garden shop. It had a small, I would say door handle, but sort of furniture knob on the top, which is used to restrain a little ring to which is sewn all the ribbons and other industrial ends. And the big and great handle had it stained to make it the same colour as your hands. We had what I would call a minimal team in terms of decoration. The costume was, you know, the minimum we could get away. Men had to wear a sash, but they ought to wear a hat, and the women should have a skirt normally the same colour. You know, it didn't mind but a certain men to bring it, and we actually just said, otherwise, and so on. First day, last day, it was very straightforward, the trouble was off, so it was easy to do. And I imagine we must be a critical state. I think I'm not going to pass on the bar first, because he has the most expensive shirt. Thank you.
about a year after that, and there I was, lying there, having me a cup of tea, and there's a video showing. So that's Western Soylent and Somerset Maids dancing. I think very lucky we were dancing against the local church door in the tower, and we were only having pipe and tabor to dance to. So again,
did they have to be quiet?
Yes. This is Pensford Old Blood. Well, that's another term one. That's my personal one. Anyway, they swapped us for one, and they didn't see Bishop Sutton on one of the hearts. And we were allowed to go and choose which state we wanted because my friend's mother had met a gentleman who had a collection of states and how we came across Austin Walker with you. So we died a few years ago at East Hart Street. And he had been collecting all across the Somerset levels, interesting bits of local folklore. And amongst his collection was a load of old over staves. This time I got a couple of Roy as well. Because we wanted to have 12 so we could dance 12. So we bought another three from him. No, four from him, so that we took our set up to 8 up to 12. And Austin Wookie was very, well, quite energetic to talk to. He'd been taught by Cecil Sharp and Douglas Kennedy. And his wife had also been taught by Cecil Sharp to dance, and Evelyn Sharp. And the Kettlewell family, in the big family in the village, had invited the Sharps down often to stay for weekends. And Mrs. Kettlewell was very keen on village life, and she brought every single member of the village their own stave. So instead of only the officers carrying the stave, everybody had their own stave to march around with. And well, I'm sure it was a lot of it was part of the influence of the Sharps. This one is one of the ones we bought from Austin, and this is Coleman's. Now there's a good chance this was actually danced with, because we've got records of a lady called Caroline Hamilton, who was the general starter there, who lived at the turn of the century. And she wrote an article, which I haven't managed to trace it out, but I have read Paul Hilton's review of that article, which says on Club Day, talking about how they dressed the sets around the village and they had their uplifting feast. But she said, then they danced, all men together, in a manner as approved of by Mr. Spurgeon. Now, Laura and I thought, I used to go, who Mr. Spurgeon might be. And we think it might be because he's the Methodist, great Methodist preacher of the day. And in fact, it's Spurgeon's College in London. And I wrote a letter to them asking them for information, and it's sort of like stolen into a pot, and I never heard any more. But maybe it's still something that's worth following up. But anyway, that's Kilmansdale. We know whether they danced. Morris danced, or they stayed danced, we're not sure yet. But anyway, at Kilmansdale, they danced. All went together. The others were copies of those. Well, that's Bolton, the one with the acorn on the top. And finally, there's this one. Now, this is officially unidentified. Even Margaret Fuller has it printed as unidentified. And so, if anybody ever finds out, I think there's quite a lot of Susanna's big urns as their symbol, but if anybody ever does find out where that urn comes from,
I think that's Baptist.
Sadly, the worst pickups are now gone, thanks to the 1960s, and a lot of people are pleasing like a they're never without somebody with them when they're outside, because if they're left unattended, even in a locked car, that invalidates the insurance. So if you do have something like this, you have to look after them and keep gloves. They're polished twice a year, so as not to give them too much hardship. Once, usually just before May Day, and the second time just before Moist Federation of the
It takes the place of practice.
Pardon? It takes the place of practice.
Yes, that's right. Yeah, you sit round and look at and polish the girls as well. So they can very well use it for the rest of the year. So that's how we got our savers, and we keep have them. You see, they've got lots of fancy bags to carry them in. We don't let them knock together. They've each got their own cupboard and their own separate area. And they're kept in the house to be sure. And so they're under lots of people on conservation all the time, because they are worth a lot of money. Each pole that you're holding there is sort of 70 to 100 pounds worth of gear, each one. So, yes, they can do the great things.
Can you remember what lives on more half time?
Yes, it was very plain. In fact, it was very coarse. It was out of it was much thicker grass than this. And let's see, it's a bit closer to one of these two. That's close to that one. There was a much coarser grass, a much stubbier, a much more rounded point.
Is it in the book?
Just with curly cues on the end.
Probably.
Yes, it's probably in the book.
We've got people have a look at this if they're local.
A lot of the book use of several hundred or thousands of friends about it. So the best way is to ask for a local museum where what they've got, say why you're interested, and so on. And if they haven't got anything particularly they can do well, that probably suggests which museum to go to. Most museums in the West in the East part of the world examples because they actually are the local things. Yeah. I see a third of these ones somewhere.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm going to be tight at the moment.
state, right, we can do the state dance, not the state. And then we got another one. So we started saying the new state dance and the old state dance, but people who just joined, they were learning two dances straight away, and we didn't know what to plot. So the first one we learned was called the original state.
Here you've got some more rubber drums. This one up there.
And we then decided secondary school doing that sort of thing, and they look actually better.
But
it is one which is like so many of the old French society, representation of the club in some way. Yeah, it does reflect on that.
What's
the
charge of collecting areas on Portland have their own green star, and they carve all the rent onto it. If you pay a full amount of rent for the line across the thing, if you only pay so much of the rent, you've got a line halfway across and there are lines and dots. And these reef stars will pass down families because the reef tends to sort of be farther to some. And there are some families still have them, but they were enormously long. They were considerably longer than these, but they were bad job.
Like for storage, which is called the last stages. Volunteers?
Right, come on out, Mrs. Sayers.
Please, just three people, please.
Yeah.
Babylon.